It wasn't your standard album, I don't think. I'm down on the ground. I don't think people listen to it and say, ah, see, that's like this. So lyrically and musically, it has a real direction. And just to pitch that and get it exactly the right thing, lyrically and musically, and tell a story, and it took a while to get done. If you're going to do your first album, you want to make it something pretty special. It's really interesting in pop music because you have, or popular music, you have people saying, oh, is this an influence? And, you know, Morricone, is that an influence, or Craig Armstrong? But the fact is that they're all taken from influences that, you know, that go much further back. So if you're going to take from those people, you're slightly deluded, because you're getting it third hand. You may as well go back to really great things that influence them. Musically, classical music has such a depth, and I think everyone would have to agree with that. It just has such a depth. So that was inspiring. And it was just finding a way to do that which doesn't have, it's not pretentious and still has the energy of something contemporary. Some of it was recorded at home on I just recorded all the singing on a really cheap 40 quid mic. And I just wrote all the string parts in my studio. Gave it to a string arranger, make sure that he's just kept it the same. It's quite quick, you know, because you've got 3 hours to get 4 songs done, so you're really against the clock. And the biggest we did was singers and orchestral players, which is about 122 players, even 40 players, which is quite a lot. You get quite a big sound from that. Essentially, you know, music works brilliantly with imagery. And it's just trying to match visuals to the music. It's great, you know, there's the Matrix. It's great to have Club Death Use. That seemed to work really well in the sense that people got excited about it. Great, you see a great commercial, great director, amazing story, cinematography, great music, fantastic. Well, I really like artists like, you know, if Velvet Underground worked with Andy Warhol, if Bowie spent so long trying to get the visual side of his stuff, you know, and I really like all that. I really like when you buy an album, and also when I was buying albums when I was young, when it first came to music, the ones I really liked had a lot of work to put in the artwork, and the whole thing was like one conception. I tried lots of things, worked with Judy Blaine, did lots of experiments. Judy Blaine, the famous stylist, really, or visual stylist, really, who came up with, was involved with Mondino at the beginning. Finally, we ended up honing it down, working with Blue Source, and they were really good because they really listened and we really communicated, and they did tell me to piss off when I was being too prescriptive to them, but yet listened, and worked with Mert Atlas and Marcus Piggott, who are great photographers, and I really admired their work, and I was thrilled to get them, and then that whole team. We spent at least a month or 2 months just getting ideas, you know, the whole thing. They were really great. Blue Source are fantastic. I really wanted to do something that was unusual. I just wanted to do things that are unusual. To present music in a different way, to have artwork, to have installations, to have the music playing. Where people walk in and go, I have not seen like something like this. And it's not like you stayed by my side or you called me a priest. With popular music, it's quite hard to do things like that, which is verging on something that is perhaps artistic rather than popular culture. David Slade directed it. He's this very intense director who's an absolute perfectionist and who is renowned for getting bands into do videos, like say a performance video, and making the band work like until they're dead and you know, begging to go home, and he's still saying, no, it's not quite right. Can you just perform it again this time? Like, so he was quite well suited to me because I really liked that, and there was no way I was ever going to say that's fine. You know, I mean, I was. If he wanted to go on forever, I could go on forever. Club to Death, you know, eventually we came up with this idea of the Rana thing for the spirit of not just that song but the whole album, you know, the various different tracks, the whole direction, which is a kind of kamikaze, sort of intense, breaking out of this reverse world and running and getting faster and faster, running down freeways faster than cars, and then going so fast that they eventually burst into flame. When you do a video, you're looking at the ideas that people submit, and they submit some ideas, and you just have to go with the best idea. And that, I think, I may be wrong, but that seemed to me the best idea.
All right.
Bands who have a producer come in, they may write a great song, and then they have a producer come in who is basically someone who's always employed for the fact that he makes things sound like radio material, and that sheen is going to be applied over the whole thing until whatever the contours that made it distinctive have been glossed over, and you know, and it's no longer distinctive. With this, I produced it myself, and I tried to keep in the recording process real control. When you had classical composers, it was one person doing as an artist, you know, it wasn't a committee, and I was trying to aspire to do it in that vision. You have to go into it thinking that, you know, you want to do something that in 20 years' time could be considered good.
Good life.